gather around, my forest friends and viewers. It's time for Nanny Annie's Family Faith in Action. What do you recall from today's gospel? It was taken from Mark 1, 29 to 39.
Jesus went to Simon and Andrew's house, and Simon's mother-in-law was sick, and Jesus healed her.
That's right, Jules. It said that there was many healed. It said the whole city was gathered at the door. Wow, can you imagine that scene? I like how that when Simon's mother-in-law was healed, she immediately got up and began to serve them. What a great response to Jesus's love and healing. What else happened in this gospel passage today? I'll give you a clue. Something really important happened the next morning.
I think I remember. Jesus went to a deserted place and prayed.
Jesus went for dessert? What did he eat?
No, not dessert. A deserted place. That means somewhere where he could be alone and quiet. Yes, I think it's a really important point. Jesus could have been caught up in the excitement of what happened the day before, that everyone was, you know, looking for him and that he was famous and he was casting out demons and he was healing people and doing great things. But he remembered the importance of quiet time and prayer time. And when the disciples found him there and said, "Come on, everyone's looking for you," Jesus said, "No, my mission is to go to other towns and share the message." It kept him from being distracted from what his call was. It's easy for us to get distracted. Do you get distracted? When?
I get distracted when I'm trying to do schoolwork and I see some of my toys and things I'd rather play with.
That's understandable. I get distracted. Sometimes I go to do one chore and then I see something else that I want to do and I start doing that. And I have to remind myself of a little motto my mother used to say. Once a job is once begun, never leave it till it's done. I find it hard to go to sleep sometimes. I get so wound up during the day, it's hard for me to just relax and get distracted about thinking about everything. Yeah, that can be a real problem.
I think drivers get distracted. One of my cousins got hit by a car.
Oh. Distracted driving is really a problem, but so is wildlife, being on the road. Today we learn the importance of quiet time and sharing those moments in our heart with Jesus. Then it becomes prayer time. For our action item this week, let's draw a picture of our favorite quiet place. Title it, My Prayer Place, and then spend some little moments there every day.
When my actions and emotions get out of control, Mama puts me on time out. She says I need to be quiet and to think.
Well, that can happen too.
Hey, Jules, maybe you can draw a picture of your time out chair.
Not a happy place.
Well, I'm sure you can think of another favorite quiet place you'd like to be, but you know, when you are sitting on the timeout chair, that's a good time to invite Jesus into your heart. Ask him to help you realize why you're there and what you could have done better, and ask for forgiveness. Be quiet until it's your time to get off. And I'm sure that Jesus's grace will help you to have a better day. Here's my prayer place. Not much of a drawer, but In the winter time, I like to sit in a rocking chair by the wood stove. Everybody, think of your quiet place and spend time there, asking Jesus to come into your heart and to keep you on focus of your call in life, whatever that might be. God bless you, and we'll see you next week on Nanny Annie's Family Faith in Action.